हेलो एंड वेलकम टू फर्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ HCIA राउटिंग एंड स्विचिंग कोर्स 2020। आवर फर्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ द डे इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू ट्रांसमिशन मीडिया। वी विल डिस्कस अ लॉट ऑफ द टॉपिक्स बट दिस इज द टॉपिक फॉर टुडे। इट्स अ वेरी शॉर्ट टॉपिक इन विच वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ट्रांसमिशन मीडिया। नाउ फॉरवर्ड, establishment of an enterprise requires a fundamental understanding of general networking concepts. So these concepts include knowledge of what defines a network as well as the original standards of technology and physical components that are used to establish enterprise networks. An understanding of the underlying network communications and the impact that such behavior has on the network is also paramount to ensuring performance effective implementation. So the objectives of this topics are: explain what constitutes a network, identify the basic components of a network, and describe the primary mechanisms for communication over a network. So we'll start now. First thing we will study is simple point-to-point Ethernet networks. Now what is a point-to-point Ethernet network? In which there are two end systems and they are connected directly with a physical medium. So these two end stations can be called as points, and this connection between them can be called as point-to-point Ethernet network because they are connected with each other through Ethernet connection. Now, a network can be understood to be the capability of two or more entities to communicate over a given medium. The development of any network relies on the same principle for establishing communication. Commonly, the entities within a network that are responsible for the transmission and reception of communication are known as these end stations, while the means by which communication is enabled is understood to be this medium. With an enterprise network, the medium exists in a variety, from a physical cable to radio waves. So here it is a physical medium, or you can say a physical cable. Now, the first medium we will talk about is coaxial cable, and there are different types of coaxial cables. You can see here standards are given here 10 base 2 and 10 base 5. Both are coaxial cables, but the difference between them is this one is thin coaxial cable and this one is thick coaxial cable, and the transmission distance they can cover is 185 meters and 500 meters respectively. Now, copper coaxial cabling commonly used to support users as part of a shared network, where there is a shared network established between the end systems. Now, coaxial cable represents a more historic form of transmission medium that may today be limited in usage with the enterprise network. As a transmission medium, the coaxial cable comprises generally of two standards, which we have studied there. Now, the speed of these standards is also written here. Support a transmission capacity of 10 Mbps transmitted as baseband signals for the respective distances of 185 meters and 500 meters respectively. Now, next medium which we will talk about is Ethernet cable or Ethernet medium. Ethernet medium is also of three standards: 10 base T, 100 base TX and 1000 base T. Now, the difference between them is because of the cables. There are two pairs of category 3, 4, 5 twisted pair cables in 10 base T, two pairs of category 5 twisted pair cables in 10 base TX, and four pairs of category 5E twisted pair cables in 1000 base T. Now, you can see the wires are wound with each other in the pairs. Now, the distance is same in all the Ethernet cables. 100 meter distance can be covered. Now, the primary physical medium is used in enterprise networks. This Ethernet medium is almost used in every enterprise network. Now, if we come on to the next medium is fiber optics, which is a very common and popular standard. You have also heard about it. Now, optical media, it is also called optical media, uses light as a means of signal transmission as opposed to electrical signals found within both Ethernet and coaxial media types. Now, fiber optic cable also have four standards which we are written here, and there are different physical medium types in this fiber optic. 10 base F is two strand fiber which can cover 2000 meters distance. So the main advantage of this fiber optic cable is that it can be used to cover a long amount of distance. And 10 base FX is two-stranded multimode fiber. Multimode fibers means which can send more than one signal at a time. Then there is 1000 base LX in which is a single mode fiber or multimode fiber. Both are supported in this standard, and their distance is 316 meters to 5000 meters. So you can see the distance is increased in this standard. And the last one is 1000 base SX, which only supports multimode fiber, and it covers the distance of 275 meters to 550 meters respectively. Now we come on to the next medium, that is called the serial medium. You can see the diagram here also, and there are two standards of this serial medium, RS-232 and RS-422, and the speed, they are defined because on the basis of the speed. RS-232 is a standard defined up to 20,000 BPS but can reach 1 megabit per second, and RS-422 can cover the speed of 1000 kilobit per second to 10 megabit per second. So serial represents a legacy form of data transmission, and standards continue to evolve as in the form of as USB. USB is also a serial medium. Now how we do the signal data encoding, this is the next topic. You can see there are two end systems, and there are the form of bits. For example, the data is being sent from one end station to the other end station in the form of bits. Now you can see here it's written one here, but it's not necessary that only one is being sent in this bit. We do the data encoding in these networks. So if there is one, that means the data is 0001. If it is 0, it's 4 zeros. If it is 2, it is 0010. If it is 3, it is 0011. Or if it is 4, it is 0100. So this is the pattern which is followed to send the values in the encoding. So signal patterns used for interpretation of communication, and encoding is used to synchronize the transmission. Now the next is collision domains. Collision domain is the point where the collision occurs within the system and between the packets. So Ethernet represents what is understood to be a multi-access network in which two or more stations share a common transmission medium for the forwarding of data. You can see here there is a common shared medium between all these end systems. The shared network is however susceptible to transmission collisions. As you can see here, the packets were being sent between the systems and they collided at this point. So a segment where such occurrences are possible is referred to as a shared collision domain. So this is called shared collision domain. End systems within such a collision rely on contention for the transmission of data to the intended destination. This contentious behavior requires each end station monitor for incoming data on the segment before making any attempt to transmit. And for that we use carrier sense multiple access collision detection, which is CSMACD. However, even after taking such precautions, the potential for the occurrence of collisions as a result of simultaneous transmission by two end stations remain highly probable. Okay, the next topic is duplex mode, which is a very easy one. You have, I think, already studied about it. Duplex mode is very simple. There are two types of duplex modes: half duplex mode and full duplex mode. Half duplex mode is simply when there are two end systems connected directly, and at a point we can only send data in one direction. For example, if we want to send data from this end station to this end station, it will only send data in this direction, and this end station will wait to receive the data, and after receiving the data then it can reply on that data. So they cannot send data at a single moment of time. But in full duplex mode there is simultaneous communication, that means bidirectional communication. At a single moment both systems can send data to each other. So this is called two modes of communication: half duplex mode and full duplex mode. So these were all the topics we studied today. In the summary we have some questions for you. First question is, which forms of cabling can be used to support gigabit Ethernet transmissions within an enterprise network? So for that the answer is, gigabit Ethernet transmission is supported by category 5E cabling and higher, and Now the answer for the first question is that gigabit Ethernet transmission is supported by category 5E cabling and higher, and also any form of 1000 base fiber optic cabling or greater. Next question is, what is collision domain? It's a very simple answer. A collision domain is a network segment for which the same physical medium is used for bidirectional communication, and data simultaneously transmitted between hosts on the same shared network medium is susceptible to a collision of signals before these signals reach the intended destination. This generally results in malformed signals either larger or smaller than the acceptable size for transmission, also known as runs and giants being received by the recipient. Last question is, what is the purpose of CSMA/CD? So CSMA/CD is a mechanism for detecting and minimizing the possibility of collision events that are likely to occur in a shared network. So CSMA requires that the transmitting host first listen to signals on the shared medium prior to transmission. So these were the simple questions and the summary of the topic. Thank you very much for watching this first topic of this HCIA complete course. The next topic of our course will be Ethernet framing, which we will discuss in the next video. Thank you very much for watching.